Welcome and hello, I have been asked for a review on the new Harlem Thrive, so here it is. I will focus on the 8-meter, on which I could get used to in the past days. If you have any questions after watching this video, don't hesitate and just ask in the comments below. To start off, I would like to talk about me, so that you can get an idea about my perspective. I am at about 84 kilograms, and for the sessions on screen I am using a 136 liquid force absolute. I use the Reden Dream Stick X with 21 meter line smith lines, and I added a splitter for the high V, the kite wants. I have owned and rode the North Orbit 24 and before that, various iterations of the Reden Supermodel. I have had the chance to fly a wide variety of kites, XR and XR Pro, Ocean Rodeo Rise, Evo D-Lab, Evo SLS, Rebel SLS, Ozone Edge, Cabrinha Nitro, and so on. My PB has been at about 15 meters for the past 12 months, and right now I'm improving on my kite loops. My goal right now is to push them above 10 meters and make them touch the horizon, basically doing a proper mega loop. In the background you see footage from 4 sessions. The footage is chronological, so you can clearly see when the spot is changed and how I got used to the kite from session to session. First session, Southbeach Sankt Peter-Ording. 23 knots, 35 plus gusts. Second session, Lakolk Römö. 25 knots, 40 plus gusts. Third session, Flensburg Fjord Kollund. 27 knots, 45 plus gusts. Fourth session, Flensburg Fjord Schausende. 34 knots, 50 plus gusts. The Thrive is light on the bar. It is so light that people coming from heavy bar pressure kites give me the feedback that they cannot feel the kite in the sky. Myself, coming from the Orbit and Supermodels before that, I had no issues to adapt towards it. Depending on what you are used to, you might have to adjust yourself on this point. This may take some time. The Thrive is fast, really fast. I have had the 10 meter out for some sessions and it was way faster than the Orbit in 9 square meters. This 8 square meter Thrive is super fast. While being almost powerless when positioned at 45 degrees, it boosts up to 110% when you quickly send it over. In strong winds it gives you a good feedback on the bar. I am referring to 30 knots plus gusting 45 plus. Even in these conditions I did not feel the urge to use the D-Power. Gusts above 50 made the 8 meter pull stronger, but not yet strong like an XR on the bar, but it was nothing to be afraid of. The speed of the kite was something that I really had to get used to when jumping. At the start I was often oversteering the kite and leaving the water after it crossed 12 o'clock. Another adjustment has been that I do steer the kite slower towards 12 than I do with other kites. While I was using the Orbit I was going for a whippier redirection of the kite. For the Thrive it is tough to get the timing 100% right. Sending the kite towards 12 slower, especially on the 8 meter, gives me the security I need for my timing. Other than that, the pull of the kite in stronger winds feels good. The power generation is very linear and controllable. I managed to up my PB 4 times during the third session to now 17.9 meters. The speed through the loop is surprisingly fast. You get up to a height that seems sufficient for a small loop and catch, then you loop the Thrive and you can feel the pressure building up on the hook in a steady and linear fashion. With the Orbit I always had the feel that it goes bonkers and janks you once the leading edge points downwards, with a strong start and sudden end of the pull. The Thrive is smooth throughout the loop. It provides a very comforting feel. After the small loop is done you will notice that it was super fast. At my first loop you could see that I was so surprised that I was pulled into an unexpected direction due to my lack of body tension and crashed the landing. For my heli loops and landings you will see a steady progression. Again the speed of the kite makes the heli loops quite different and unwillingly tight. I do expect to spend some more hours on the kite to get comfortable with my heli loops again. The Thrive drifts quite well. Clips of this are not in the video, but I had multiple occasions of when the kite was without line tension. It drifts with the wind until it catches again. Orbits in the same situation will fall directly onto your head. The Thrive makes me remember the Supermodel, which shows the same behavior. I do not have any comparison towards wave kites, due to my lack of interest in that area. I hope you enjoyed the video and got some useful information from my descriptions. I am looking forward for a looping session tomorrow and will maybe upload a new video in the upcoming days. Until then, enjoy your kites.